L minus L to L. I get a very surprising result is that the Hamiltonian will be equal to Lagrangian when the function is homogeneous. Not for the with homogeneous M. But not for only for kinetic curve. I told you, if you have a harmonic oscillator like that, if your potential is also homogeneous function, same results. So for any class of the Lagrangian with homogeneous form, you can get Hamiltonian equal to the L.
So, case if Hamiltonian is equal to Lagrangian, when?
Only when the Lagrangian is considered as a homogeneous function of the order 2. I mean, when the particle is free particle, or when the potential is also second order. If you have a cubic, or if you have like 1 over a square cube, or but this alpha should not be G should not be only integer number. I mean, G can be any number, even negative number. But I cannot remember any example easily that when the homogeneous order is negative or something. But can be. So G is a general exponent. It can be two anything. Normally, in the classical mechanics, is considered as a second order. So G is two, actually, in classical mechanics. So this is an application of that. So this question has a the question has a lot of meaning actually. You can define that very, very interesting equation. So let me to write this equation Pi d Q I d t 2m. And I can write this Pi d Q I 2m dt. Yes? I don't know if you are familiar with the something called action principle in classical mechanics. Integral of Lagrangian over the time is called action, S. Sometimes they call it by A, it depends to how you write. So in one side you have the action. I know that there is a 2, but this 2 doesn't care. It's not very important for me. So I have in one side I have an action, mechanical, classical mechanical. And one side I have sigma pi d q I. What does it mean, sigma pi d q I? If I make a space, I call it this phase space, and we will use that. The trajectory of the particle will be like p as a function of qi. P dqi, what does it mean? P dqi is that. This is the dqi. This is the area. Sigma P dqi is the total area, total area of this surface. This is the total area. Total area of phase space. Is equal to the action. If you use that, I will use this equation next chapters. But if you use this equation in the quantum mechanics, so you will get the Bohr-Sommerfeld quantization rule. The old quantum mechanics, just from here. The observation is that the area of the phase space is given by the action. I know there is a 2, but anyway, you can manage that. So it will be proportional to the action, at least proportional. So if you have any idea about the quantization of the particle here, you get the quantization about the action or vice versa. Just as an example, so can you write this integral, integral phi dq, integral phi dq over the whole space, so this is given the action. So I will send you this, so you will have this week maybe, this week means the Wednesday, I will send you 2 or 3 questions for the next week. Every week you need to do something. So I will give you some mechanical system. This mechanical system, you can get P from the as a function of Q, and you need to perform the integration and find the action. For example, for harmonic oscillator, you know the Lagrangian is Hamiltonian. It's P over 2,
plus potential. Element square.
This, huh? So if you limit yourself to the surface with the constant energy, so from here you can get the P, and you can, this is the easy example actually, 2mE. But this integral is not very easy to do because it is a counter integral. You need to read the chapter 7, chapter 8 of the Arfkin for the complex integrals. Anyway, I will give you something I can solve. Well, I think for today is enough because what I expected I already explained to you, so we can stop. Thank you.